When you have a breakthrough of gas here, what can you do? You can choke the well, or you need to have something that can blank off the zone, where you could just say, I don't want to produce here, because here I have just gas. Then you can open the choke again. Then you can open the choke and you can start producing the oil.
The first function of inflow control technology is to balance the initial non-uniform oil production in horizontal wells. The goal is to even out the difference between higher and lower flow rates in the various production zones. That way, you drain the oil at a slower pace in the higher flow rate zones, which in turn means that you delay water and gas coning in these areas. As a result, you also delay water and gas breakthrough in the wellbore. However, although delayed, coning and subsequent breakthrough will inevitably occur. That's when the second and most fundamental purpose of the technology comes into play, choking the water and gas production downhole. It is precisely by choking the unwanted fluids down in the reservoir, zone by zone, that you avoid having to choke the entire well at the surface. Because the well is able to remain open for oil production, regardless of water and gas coning, the well's lifetime is extended. This improves both the daily production of oil and ultimate oil recovery. Inflow control technology can be divided into three main categories. The first category, invented in the 1990s, was the inflow control device, or ICD. This was the first device to delay water or gas breakthrough by balancing the initial non-uniform oil production. However, it cannot choke either water or gas once the fluids eventually enter into the production stream. To solve this issue, a second category was invented in 2006, the Autonomous Inflow Control Device, or AICD. The AICD also delays premature water and gas breakthrough, but will, unlike the ICD, also choke smaller percentages of water and moderate percentages of gas after breakthrough occurs. However, successful AICD performance is limited to reservoirs with medium to heavy viscosity oils. To improve on the AICD performance, a third inflow control technology category was invented in 2012, the Autonomous Inflow Control Valve. Naturally, the AICV delays premature water and gas breakthrough, but most importantly, it was developed to choke back unwanted gas and water by over 90%. In reservoirs ranging from ultra-light to ultra-heavy oil. It is through these three developmental stages that inflow control has matured into a technology with the capability to directly address and resolve the inherent issue of excessive gas and water production in horizontal wells.